Welcome back to the Dabcast. Today might be lose day, but tomorrow's Wednesday.
Yep.
Yeah, so
we're comedians here.
Victor was doing the intro, but you know, something that I want to say is welcome back to the Dadcast. Colin is actually having his firstborn child in like a month from now. It's crazy. Colin's significant other is pregnant.
I know.
Colin had unprotected sex.
How does it feel that you're going to be a dad soon?
It's been a little stressful in these times, we're keeping our head up.
How's she doing?
You know how they be. They're a little
women.
Ooh, cuckoo.
Am I right?
Cuckoo. Yep.
La La Land.
I know.
Okay, we passed the minute mark. According to Game Grumps, I was watching a Let's Play recently. This is actually, I thought it was 5 minutes, but it's actually just a minute.
It's only a minute
that
for
can't
swearing.
Say the bad boy words.
Okay.
All right, so I actually have a topic.
Like poopy head.
That Victor probably knows about, and Colin might not, but Colin can contribute to it because of Xenoblade 2. So,
okay.
I'm a gamer.
I've recently seen this like uproar on Twitter over this. I don't know what exactly the anime is called, but it's like Uzaki-chan or some shit.
Oh yeah, Uzaki-chan wants to hang out. Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah,
like sure is.
Yeah. Okay. And people are outraged. So, and I'm going to be honest. I didn't know too much about it until earlier today. I thought the problem was that. Oh, she's underage, but no, she's like 20 years old. I thought I was under
no,
the impression
she
that
is a college freshman or university,
like 14 or something, and people were freaking out.
I think
out
I know where this is going.
It was like a little girl.
She's legal. She's 22.
And people
I believe.
Are like doing like these. I checked the wiki. It was like 19 at the start, and then it said like 20 at like chapter 22, I think, or some shit. I don't know how long the manga chapters are. I was just doing some cross-referencing.
They're just like little, like they're like one-shots almost.
When I was seeing
one-shot.
This outrage about it, first of all, I like to say, because she is 20, I can say this. She's pretty hot, to be honest.
Yeah. She got some milk.
Her mom's just as hot.
I'm just saying she could drown people in the milk. I'm just saying.
Were you going to say anything else about that?
Shout out to my women. That's what I also wanted to add. No, I have more to add. People are doing these, like in the outrage on Twitter, people are doing these, like, redesigns where they're like, I am absolutely appalled and disgusted by this.
Oh, yeah,
this
character
design. Here's what a 20-year-old is supposed to look like. And it's like, they pretty much have drawn the same thing, but she's, like, taller. And I was like, okay, because I saw one of the replies was like a Japanese person and they were like being like, it looks like you just whitewashed her. And I like to say this guy's wording was a little oof, but it was funny. He said the one on the left, which was the redraw, looks like a white to me. While the one on the right looks more like a Japanese person. And I thought, on one hand, I mean, that immediately it kind of invalidates that person's argument because a Japanese person's being like, yo, shut the fuck up. And they even threw out like, oh, isn't this what you would also complain about, like cultural appropriation? Like, I don't think it was the person's like, I don't think, it didn't seem like they were the type of person who would be like outraged. Like, be like, oh, this is cultural appropriation. I think it was more over them like, using something they would say to them, you know? And I thought it was funny. I thought it was quite funny because it's like, okay, the only big difference I can see in their redraw besides the art not looking that great and her tits not being quite as massive. They were still pretty big in the one I saw. They just made them taller and like her having like longer arms and shit. And I thought it was interesting. And alongside the Japanese person who responded to it, I was like, all right, let me cross-reference and see, like, oh, like, let's see what a 20-year-old is supposed to look like. I went to the wiki.
Mm-hmm.
It said the girl, Uzaki, was 4'11". And I believe I searched up the average height of a Japanese woman, and I'll double-check real quick, was 4'9". I'm going to check, though.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see.
For our people that don't live in America, that's 149 centimeters or 150 if you want to round it.
Sorry, let me correct myself. It was not 4'9". It's 5'1 for women in Japan. So there's that. It's literally 2 inches off.
That's 155 centimeters for our metric users.
Yeah, so it's literally 2 inches off of the average height for Japanese women. I'd like to say the average height for Japanese men is 5'6". I'm just throwing that one out there.
Are you Japanese?
No, I'm 6'5". and now let's see the average height of an American woman. She, on average, the height of an adult female is 5'4". Right under 5'4". It's 5'3.7". So it's like, it's not even that big of a difference. In Japan, it's literally 2 inches off of the average height. It's not like she's fucking 4'2" with biggest hits. And it doesn't even matter. There are short people in this world. Like, it's so, like, I don't
understand. Colin, okay. I sent an image of her.
I don't understand the issue. Like,
yeah, I know what you look
like with all this right. whole thing. Cause it's like, I know the main issue that they have is she has huge tits. I understand that. But
huge bazongas.
But let's not act like there aren't women with huge tits, like when they're like skinny, like, and I'm not even talking about like ones that might have like implants or anything. There are women that are skinny and just legitimately naturally have big ass tits, all right? It's I don't understand what, like, and this whole thing of, oh, what they're supposed to look like. Does every 20-year-old woman look the same? Across the globe, like, it's so ridiculous, and it's also just like demeaning. Like, I was fucking disgusted and appalled by the artist's work. Like,
I thought you were gonna bring up, because I saw something else related to the same thing. One of the redraws.
I think I might know
the character is like fat.
Oh, I saw that one as well. I saw that one as well.
And the Japanese guy was like saying, oh, obesity, you whitewashed
her, normal for Japan.
Yeah, which implies that, like, white people are just like, you know, we're sitting over here all like fat.
I saw another redraw where it basically made her look like it's not normal very fat
for women to have
and lanky.
Massive tits, but it's then normal for women to be obese? Like, no.
Yeah.
No, every...
Yes, because Slay Queen, yes,
that's why I thought
period.
You were going with that one.
It's so dumb. I saw that one as well, and I remember, because I saw that one and the one that I was talking about, I couldn't remember what the other one was. So I was like, I'll just go with the one that I remember. It's just so ridiculous, like, imposing, like, your own ideas of what they should look like. And in the end, even if they were right, it's a drawing. It's literally a drawing. Like,
Why would they choose now to complain about this?
Because it's just getting its It's just getting its anime adaptation, and that's why.
On the topic of the whole the obese one, I have to bring up a take from H3H3, and I don't agree with H3H3 on many things anymore, but I think his take is really good when it comes to like plus size modeling. And I think it's fair because he's fat, you know, he's not skinny.
No, he's just chunky.
He's overweight, you know. And, you know, whatever, if that's what you really want to do, you should know that it's not healthy, but if you really just, like, I'm a little bit overweight, like, if I'm going to be real, you know, step away from the 6'5" quarterback bit.
No, it's just because of Corona. You just haven't been able to hit the gym.
I'm slightly, you know, I'm not like obese, but like I definitely could be healthier, without a doubt. And I understand that, and it's not healthy, and it's not good. But it's like you have this whole thing about like being like, oh, it's so not good that modeling shows like all these women that are practically like they have like anorexia or something with how skinny they want to be, and complaining about it and how unhealthy it's, because of course that's unhealthy if they're like. Or if they're being anorexic to be a model, that is horrible, you know? And there's the whole thing about, oh, they have, you know, like, they have really, like, bad, like, they're the most insecure people out there, despite, like, objectively being the hottest, you know, or, like, nicest looking. But then it's like you're gonna you're gonna complain about that, but then you're going to go and like be like Yas Queen Slay for like plus size modeling.
Yeah, both are unhealthy.
And it's not healthy for it's not healthy to be overweight.
No, they're just big boned. They're just big boned.
And also it's not like it's not healthy physically and it's not healthy mentally. Like if you're out of shape and all that, it's not good for you. It's not. No matter how like confident you are of a person, that's still gonna weigh down on your mental state. And of course it's it's horrible for your for how you are like physically and your chance of
number
being,
one
like,
killer in America, heart disease.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Well, I even remember when H3HD was talking about this on his podcast, because it was one from a while ago, I think. I think I just saw a clip or something. It might have been like in the past few months, but I don't know. It was a clip that I got in my recommended. I was just like, oh, I'll check it out. He brought up in this, like, because it was all about, like, if she was like the first plus size model to be like on the front of like a certain magazine or some shit. And it's.
Oh, yeah, it was, I believe, Calvin Klein is what
I don't know. I don't know. Either way, it probably goes for whether it was the Calvin Klein one or not. Mm-hmm. Just like with the, like, what we consider to be normal models, and their stuff is photoshopped, the one of the plus-size model was photoshopped to hell as well. Like,
no, it wasn't.
Oh, my
Wait,
God.
Wait, what? To make her look better?
Yeah, like, was, like, stretch marks weren't showing and shit when like she wasn't just like a little chunky like
oh
she,
so they're like trying to be like oh this is natural
yeah
but then they're still
oh okay
she, it's natural it's healthy and when the same people that like
okay.
complain the same people that complain about like the Photoshop being used and how practically anorexic some like what we considered standard like normal modeling to be and how unhealthy it is for people to see that and think that's what's natural because of Photoshop and all of that, how that's unhealthy. The same Photoshop and shit, it was being used on the plus size models. And it's like it's reinforcing just as like an unhealthy mindset as with the normal ones. You know?
Mm-hmm. I completely get you.
That's really neglectful on their part to just to not think that through. Like
it's just a double standard. Mm-hmm. Well, the people that took the picture, they don't give a shit. They're just doing it for money, and just be like, oh, look what we did. We're woker now, you know.
But if we can point that,
I like that
inconsistency out, and it's like,
well, yeah, it's stupid, but it's just like. I hate to keep using this word, but like woke Twitter and those types of people, they don't care. It's just it's just to push the thing. It doesn't matter how many inconsistencies there are within their own like line of reasoning or whatever. It doesn't matter because we're wrong and bigots and we just want supermodel girlfriends.
Women to not be fat.
And you know what? You know what? To our audience out there, you're right. I do want a supermodel girlfriend. You're absolutely right. I want a super hot cosplay girlfriend. You are damn right.
I don't want people to be fat.
Yeah, I don't either.
Damn
straight. I'm not fat, but I'm definitely overweight.
No, you're just a chonker.
Never give up, audience.
And you know, there's another thing. There's another thing that I just remember from the HVH take. I don't want to. This is so sidetracked from talking about the 20-year-old with huge tits. But
her name is Hana Uzaki.
But
don't call her by her.
But fuck. Oh god damn it! It's also like to
it's
have
okay.
plus size modeling. It's so like even if like normal models are a little bit like. What some of those things they do to keep themselves like in shape isn't healthy. It's also really hard to lose weight and all that. And they have to, even if they go a little too far in some cases, they have to put a lot of work in to get like what objectively would be considered like a perfect body. You know, like they're healthy.
Yeah.
They are very like, they might be somewhat muscular, like they're toned. I'm not saying like they're like a fucking bodybuilder. That's a whole lot of that's hard work, and for someone who just they fucking eat to stroll up and have the same job, whether it's same, it probably doesn't pay the same, but you know what I mean. to have the same sort of job. It's viewed and they the don't, same, yeah. They don't really have to put any work in. They're just fat. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe they have a little bit of trouble getting the clothes on, but... I don't know. But this sort of shit has always pissed me off. Like, getting back to the anime girl topic. It's just like, you're putting your own standards on people.
Yeah.
And I'm going to say it. This is probably, this one isn't a good point. This is just one that I'm frustrated that people are actually angry over this. In reality, these people that are really getting bent out of shape and doing these redraws over of what she's supposed to look like, you know...
I want to make her 300 pounds.
You know
she's like me.
Ugly, disgusting pieces of trash. Absolutely. You know they look fucking gross. Absolutely. And nobody, no man, no woman, no anything has ever wanted to fuck them in their lives. So they're mad at a fucking drawing that has some big old titties that people find attractive. Because I'm not going to lie.
You're mad.
I looked at those titties and I was like, fuck yeah, bro. That's fucking hot.
Why the hell did people wait till now to like...
It's just because
like,
the anime.
Rhea's Grammarly, for example.
Victor was saying this early,
high school
like,
exactly what I said.
Victor was saying this
No, but
earlier,
it's okay for her, Colin, because she's like... I think, what? She's... 18 at the beginning of the
19,
series, and she's like 20 something now.
It said
19
on the manga.
Wiki. Oh no, I was talking about Rhea's grammar.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were talking about Uzaki still.
Okay, let's see. Oh wow, this is definitely a Wikipedia to say the least.
There's a couple of other redrawing fiascos that I know less about, but I do want to bring up after this.
I saw whatchamacallit, a redraw of the frog girl from My Hero, and all they did was
Momo.
Make her.
Her and Momo, they just made them black.
They made them
Momo,
black.
Momo, they made fat as well, and of course, they nerfed their tits a little bit. And I'm just like, you know, I'm gonna. We're okay. Let me make sure word this correctly, because of course, even though. I feel like any fucking like-minded and somewhat intelligent person could figure out what we see as the problem here. Let me specify. The issue isn't that a character is black. The issue is that you're now saying there's something disgusting and wrong about the previous design and now saying, okay, now that they're black and fat, now they're good. This is what they should look like. And it's like... They're fucking Japanese, first of all. Like, they live in Japan. Believe it or not.
Japanese people are very, like, what's the word? Xenophobic? They don't...
Well,
they're disconnected from that stuff.
It's not even that.
I don't mean to break up the conversation, but I did do a recheck for high school DxD characters, and it said for the first years, they're usually around 16, 17. Second years are 17, 18. And then third years in university are 19 and up. So going by the show, Rias is like 19 to 21 at best.
But
at oldest,
back
my bad.
To the original thing. It's not even... I wouldn't even say Japanese people are... xenophobic. It's like I'm sorry, like they're really like as somebody who went to Japan, it's not like I lived there, but you know, I took a trip there.
Bro, you saw subtitles under what they
said. Yeah, it's not like it's not like America. It's not a fucking mixing pot. It's a bunch of Asian people, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
there's not they're not even xenophobic. It's just it's literally portraying the country. Like, the people in the country as they are. You're not going to see, like, a bunch of white people or a bunch of black people there, you know? Like, they're there.
Oh, I think I've had the same experience when I went to China back when.
Uh-huh.
I saw only Chinese people, basically. And I saw one black person on the train, but he, like, zoomed by.
That's what I mean. Not every country is like America. Like, they're not going to have... Like, the cast of an anime that takes place in Japan, like, it's a fictional world, but based off of Earth. Like, of course, quirks and shit, that isn't real, obviously. But, you know, there's some real fucking idiots out there. But it's still in Japan, all right? Like, it's just Japanese people. Like, I don't even know what else to say about it. It's just portraying the mm-hmm. people of the country as what they are. It's just a bunch of Asian people. There's only, like, a few, like, I think one of, I know there's the one black guy, Rock Lock, one of the professional heroes.
Yeah, Rock
Lock. And then, like, I think one of the Class B students. From my hero. Like, I think it's, no, it's not the mushroom girl, it's the pony girl. I don't think they've shown her in the anime yet. Is, like, yeah, she's an American exchange student. And that's pony it. Girl. That's it.
Ella Klein? What?
Oh, my God.
2 out of 10.
Oh man, I don't like. There's no right way they should be drawn. I don't. Oh my God, it's so. And I what and really pisses me.
They also got to remember the culture is completely different from what it is. In
another
the States.
Point is, and I'm always going to bring up points like this when, because I think it's important, even though, because like okay, this is changing an Asian character, even though I think it's fair to say this might come out a little like whitewashy or whatever, but I think it's fair to say that like not including like clothing or hairstyles or anything, a lot of anime characters' skin color, I think it'd be fair to say they look more white than they do like tan Asian sort of color, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I can agree on that.
But okay. That's aside from the point even. They are Asian, mm-hmm. primarily Japanese in a lot of anime. Not all, of course. Like, yeah, there's plenty of anime.
Canonically,
that,
it's usually. Always they are Asian because yeah. these are mm-hmm. like in Japan.
And, yeah, in a certain anime, like they take place in like another world, or it's you know, or like Attack on Titan. Like, yeah, I don't care about your little nerd language, okay? Or an Attack on Titan is like the like it's like German. Like, even though it's not like Earth,
yeah.
Like most of the characters besides like Mikasa would be like German Poland.
Oh, like Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood.
I just said
Brotherhood,
German.
Where it's like,
Germany or Poland. I had to correct myself. So
the places
yeah, yeah,
on
same
the
with
map
Full Metal Alchemist,
like,
yeah.
separated. Yeah.
It would be a more European setting. It's not Earth, but it's
yeah.
similar. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
but then there are
somewhat,
ones that,
yeah,
as
yeah.
you said, isekai are just completely fantasy worlds like ReZero.
Yeah,
but
fantasy.
A lot of ones, as we were saying before, they're just in Japan. They just are.
Yeah, I think most shows comprise of being in Japan.
Yeah.
I'd say what,
I'll trust you, Victor.
60
you
or 50.
Well, any slice of life show that's just gonna be in Japan. Like literally any of
oh,
them.
Like if it's like I want to say what 80% or at least 90 all in Japan.
Yeah, I mean Beyblade, that's Japan. At least Metal Fusion
is it?
Yeah,
lose?
Yeah, because in Metal Masters
really
in lose. The World Championships, they're Team Japan.
Oh.
Yeah, Team Gang Gang Galaxy, okay. and Jenga, and then that's Team Japan. It's not like in the first series, Metal Fusion, they weren't like going around saying, this is Japan. But in the second one, where it's like they're going around the world and fighting teams from different countries, it's stated many, many, many times they're from Japan. I don't know about like 1999 Beyblade, like the Plastic Generation or Beyblade Burst. I don't know. Mm-hmm. What they take place in, if they even take place in, like, Earth, the real world.
Not a true fan.
I don't, yeah, I know, I'm only a Metal Fight fan, which I think most people would agree with. I'm just saying.
Me, you, my titanium Beyblade after school.
Your Beyblade destroyed. But fuck, I got sidetracked. Yeah, so most of them yeah. are Japanese. And these people redrawing them as black, saying this is what they should be. You know,
yep.
good
so
and well. Like for
like...
example, like Nessa from Pokemon Sword and Shield, when that guy did the white mod for her. Like I know it's a meme, but like
oh,
shit like
great.
That. Like if you whitewash like a black character, at mm-hmm. least in America, I'm not. It's probably it would vary in other countries. At least in America, that would be a huge deal. And it, you know, that's true. Like, if there's, like, Luke Cage, like, if you suddenly made him a white dude, yeah, that's fucked up. You shouldn't do that. But I don't think it's fair that there's this double standard about it, where these anime mm-hmm. characters, oh, they should be black, or they should be fat.
Yeah.
Or Team Aqua from Pokemon. I always bring this up when I bring up the Nessa example. And the original Pokemon Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald, the leader of Team Aqua, Archie, the admin, Shelly and Matt, and all the grunts, they're all, like, white-skinned. Even though the first, like, if we're going to get into, like, comparing the Pokemon world to the real world, Kanto, Johto, mm-hmm. Hoenn, and Sinnoh, the first four generations of Pokemon, were all based off of Japan. So you could say they're supposed to be
jelly-filled donuts.
You could say they're supposed to be Asians. But either way, they're Asian or mm-hmm. white dudes from Europe, America, whatever. They changed all of Team Aqua. Literally all of the Team Aqua, the admins, the leader, and all the grunts, all black in the Alpha Sapphire and Omega Ruby remakes. All black. And personally, I do think the redesigns for them were really good. But I don't think it's fair.
I do agree. They look nice.
I don't think it's fair that we're going to fucking lose our minds over if a like a black character were to be whitewashed. And mm-hmm. But then if the vice versa happens, it's fine. And I understand, like, there's a whole point of, oh, well,
it's gotta
black
be diverse,
people have been discriminated against, and it needs to be more diverse, and all that. But it's like, no, I'm sorry. If you're gonna say one thing's the problem, then the other thing needs to be a problem, too, if it's the same thing. Like, I don't fuck sorry, with that sweetie. Sort of double standard. And let the little, or not mm-hmm. little girl, let the 20-year-old college student have her big old fucking milkers, all right? Jesus Christ. It's just like, this is what I was trying, when we first started this. It's just like Xenoblade 2. Oh my
oh, okay.
God.
I was about to ask, when does Xenoblade tie well, into
it's the same thing. People fucking freaked okay. out over the characters being designed by a hentai artist, or not even all of them. Just like some of the main ones, like Rex, Nia.
Yeah, I thought people were just like, oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. No, not everyone. I think it's awesome. And I think Pyra and Mithra
I agree.
Are super hot.
It's good.
But yeah. I'm going to go try to find a screenshot of it. Like, mm-hmm. there's ones where people are fucking freaking out. Oh, what's her name? Colin, okay. what was the snow bear name?
Ursula?
No, not the little girl, not Ursula. The one with, like, absurdly huge tits.
Ooh.
Dahlia. Oh, Dahlia, right?
Yeah, yeah, the snowman, the abominable snowman.
Yeah, wasn't her name Dahlia, I think?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to try to get the screenshot real quick, because...
Absolute creature, that thing.
Creature? Hold on, how do you spell it?
I got it, don't worry about yeah. it. And it'll okay. show a picture of her.
She's like a half furry. So weird.
Yeah, like she's got really like big, like bear monster, like forearms and paws, and then legs.
I got very confused. I don't know how to feel about that.
I see. I want to think. I know what you're talking about.
You probably do. I'm about to send it in Discord.
I mean, it's a smaller character. But...
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, it's not even. It's a completely optional character. Even I just sent it.
Oh, yeah, got you.
Why are they
yep.
so big?
Well, they are huge. I'm not going to act like they're
God,
realistic,
they're so
but it's like, one, it's a video game. Two, it's a fantasy game. And then you're going to say, wow, the character designs for Xenoblade 2 literally can't get any more ugly, unappealing, inconvenient, overcomplicated, or misogynistic at this point. Xenoblade 2.
That can't be a very popular opinion, though, for the type of people that play Xenoblade 2.
No, I think a lot of people disagreed with it, but there are a lot of other tweets and articles. Of course, a lot of them are about Dahlia specifically.
Well, articles are just trying to do it for, like...
Well, of course. Articles don't give a shit. They just want to get the clicks. Like, of course, there's some
the
tweets...
It looks like the May Lunar skin when it first came out, which has, like, the tabletop butt... Overwatch, the May Lunar skins when they first came out, and her waist was really small. That this image reminds me a lot of that because of how she's posed right now. Because
yeah,
she has a very arched
the full
back.
Anterior pelvic tilt, or whatever.
And
yeah,
okay. And if we're gonna take it a step further as well, okay, first of all, I would like to read out a tweet, which is mm-hmm. someone like. Defending the character design, saying this is Dahlia from Xenoblade Chronicles 2, the oh-so-infamous sex object character. You should probably play the game or at least do a quick search about the character before whining like a little bitch. And that's the truth. A lot of these people never played Xenoblade 2. You're going to have people like Victor, that one guy. We all know about, oh, Xenoblade 2 is just like Pokemon, but with women. And it's like, oh my God, it's so dumb.
Wait, what are they trying to say with that, though? Like, you a search of...
Like, I guess that you just own fucking sex slaves. Women are all slaves. And it's like, one... There's plenty of male blades. As well. Yeah, there's plenty of male blades in the game. And two, you know any of the people that said that didn't play a second of Xenoblade 2. And another thing, is Dahlia is literally supposed to be a rabbit. Something known as, like, a sexual animal.
Wait, that's...
You know what I mean? Because rabbits fuck like crazy.
My Lop Bunny fans.
Like, oh, okay.
That's the whole thing. Like, her hair, like, it goes to two things. They're supposed to be big ears. I don't know why her hands are so fucking weird, because, like, those are... I don't think rabbits have those sorts of hands.
They're awful. Her feet, too. Oh, my God, dude.
Oh, yeah. But, yeah, Dahlia is supposed to be a snow rabbit. Rabbits are known for fucking like crazy. Overall being sexual, like bunny suits and, like, things like strip clubs like that. Or, like, Playboy, okay. It's Playboy. Literally, like, it's the symbol of Playboy. It's a fucking bunny.
Mm-hmm. I see.
It's known as a sex icon. But that doesn't mean Dahlia boils down to, let me suck Rex's cock. You know, like, it's just so dumb. Because it's the same thing. They'll say the same shit about Pyra and Mithra. And not a single time. At any point in the...
I'll definitely defend Mithra, because Mithra is, like, super developed, especially with, like, the DLC and shit.
Yeah, well, it's just, like, not a single time, whether you want to say they're developed or not, not a single time was their character just look at tits. And you can even have sexual characters, like Lust from Full Metal Alchemist.
Yeah.
That's, like, part of her, well, of course, that's kind of a bad example, because, of course, the character that embodies lust is going to be sexual. But that's what I'm trying to say. Like, you can have characters that are, like, sexual and all that, and it's not a bad character. It's part of them. Or even, like, somebody like Elsa from ReZero. I wouldn't say she's exactly a sexual character. She has some big-ass tits that are practically falling
she's
out.
She's provocative.
But, she's provocative. Yeah, provocative. She's, like, flirty, you know? She's, like, a flirty, like, killer and shit like that. And it makes her an interesting character. And none of those, not Mithra, Pyra, Dahlia, Elsa, it's not, wow, look at these big old milkers we have. Wow, Rex, Subaru, you want to suck
fat
on them?
Bazonga.
No point. That's just a character design. It's just a fucking character design. Like, get over it. Like, oh my God, like, and then, like, let's say Pyra was fucking 500 pounds in Xenoblade 2. Am I allowed to be like...
She probably was.
Am I allowed to be like, wow, this is so fucking vile and disgusting? Like, no, I would get fucking obliterated for that. And it's not like people said these things and no one, like, disagreed with them. As I said, people did. But it's just like, you don't even know what their character is. And you're mad that they're, like, they're attractive characters. They got big tits, big ass, you know. You're mad about that. And you're making more of an issue about it and more of a thing about them being, like, sexual than the game even does.
True.
They're turning them more into sex objects than the game ever did. Like, it's always pissed me off. And the same thing's going on with this character, Uzaki. It's so dumb. And, you know, another point, I'll bring a cynical point of view, even though this runs counter to what I was just saying. But you know what? Let's say they were just made just to be fucking sexual and hot. You know what? Whether you like it or not, sex sells, all right? You put some big old titties on something, people are going to buy
it. Yeah, brother.
All right? Get over it. It's not like Overwatch. Which I can't believe people actually used to complain about. Oh, I can't believe Tracer has a fucking victory pose where she's looking over her shoulder and she has a nice ass. this is so bad, when it's like Overwatch is one of the most diverse games out there, dude. May is chunky. She's pretty.
I'm sure that one is the minority too, because yeah, it is a very diverse game.
Yeah, well, I remember like I don't think this fucking idiot really does anything anymore, but remember like the one woman, Anita Sarkeesian or whatever?
That name rings a bell. Who was she?
She was like a really big like feminist SJW. I'm sure Leafy made plenty of videos on her back in the day.
Oh yeah, it was probably like one of the
remember she made a video. Yeah, in fact, I think Leafy made a video about her video about this. Made a video about how sexist Overwatch is. And how, wow, look at these hot females. They have like D.Va, Tracer, Widowmaker. And I you know, somebody like her is just baiting for views because she knows people hate her, but she's still going to get the views off it. And I remember in the video, what frustrated me most is she literally doesn't mention May or Zarya. May, who is large and chunky. She is overweight. Like, I'm not even going to be like, oh, I'm not going to even feed into like, like, I'm going to be more serious about this, not even feeding into the bit of, she's not fat. She's like, May's on the fatter side, all right? Her legs are massive. They are massive, she's dog.
Chunky.
Weren't people saying it was just the coat for a while?
Well, that's what it seems like on her torso, because her coat's huge. But she has leggings on for her legs. So like.
And they're like skin tight? Okay,
yeah,
okay.
So there's no reason. Or at least I've always been under the impression. For me, I look at that and I'm like, okay, it's weird if she's like she was in Antarctica, she was like cryo frozen or whatever, for I don't know the amount of time, but it was probably like a few years. So I don't know why she'd be wearing leggings in Antarctica, but they don't seem like pants or anything. They look like skin tight leggings to me. Maybe I've always looked at her character design. Maybe they aren't leggings, but I've always looked at them and be like, those look like skin tight leggings to me, you know? And I'm pretty positive.
Guess if you look at her and see, you know,
I'm pretty positive I'm right about that.
And that would be the point, yeah.
Yeah, but it's like, yeah, she's large. She's kind of fat. And then Zarya is muscular as hell. Like, it's, there is diverse body types. And then Roadhog, I know he's a man, so it doesn't matter if the male characters have diverse. Or I even think in the woman's video, Anita Sarkeesian's video, she brought up how the males have diverse body types. There's a fat guy with Roadhog, fucking anorexic junkrat. There's a robot. But then when she brought up the females, she didn't bring up May or Zarya. And it's so dumb. Like,
Who?
Oh, my God. And it's not like those were even characters that were, like, added after release. Like, they've been in there since the game's release. And even more diverse characters have been added since. Like,
oh, yeah, Baptiste.
Baptiste.
Who else?
That's a black dude.
Anna.
Egyptian. And she's a fucking grandma, dog.
Yeah. What, Echo's a robot,
Orisa's a robot. Doomfist. A black guy. Sombra, Hispanic.
Yeah.
Even though I guess she's conventionally, but Sombra's conventionally attractive, so she doesn't mean anything. If she's not 800 pounds, doesn't matter. Moira, I'm sorry, maybe she's some people's thing, but
German,
Moira's German, and I don't find her attractive in the slightest. She's quite disgusting to me. She's probably gets a few people off, but. It's such a diverse cast, and it's only become more diverse.
Yeah,
it's so dumb. Like, I want to say, yeah, you know what? Since the game came out, Sigma, he was the first white male added since the game was released. Like, there were already a few in there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Before the game's released,
Soldier.
Okay. But Soldier's gay. So even there, even though though I think the soldier being gay thing is pretty forced. They just kind of shoehorned it in there. I feel like Tracers felt a whole lot more natural when they did it. And the same thing go for Soldier. But I'm just saying. Sigma was first white dude added since the game's release. Because they added Anna, African or Egyptian, which is in Africa, female. Sombra, Hispanic, female. Orisa, robot, but portrayed to be female. Doomfist, black male, Moira, older white woman, like middle-aged white woman, Bridget, young white Swedish girl, because she's Torbjorn's daughter.
Tomboy.
I don't remember the order after this, but Baptiste, black dude. Then I think Sigma was the next one added. He was like character 30 or 31, I think, and the game started off with 21 characters. So it took like 9 or 10 additions to add another white dude. And that's fine. That's fine. I'm not being like, what the fuck, no Blizzard? Add more white guys in. But I'm just saying, like, the notion that Overwatch needs to be more diverse is so ridiculous because it's so diverse already and it's only becoming more and more.
No. No more white people.
It's so ridiculous. Yeah, but we should probably move on to something else. But in conclusion, Uzaki-chan is hot, has big tits. I would put my penis in them. Everybody stop complaining.
For marriage?
Yes.
Oh, okay, yes. Chance.
And it's only a plus that she's 4'11". That might be the best part.
Oh yeah, why is that?
I just like short girls. I just like short girls.
Okay. I was a little intrigued by that. Okay.
I mean, like, as long as you're like 5'6" and under, you know. Mm-hmm. I know, for the cosplay cuties that I know are just filling out that application and the description so much. The height question was optional, but you know.
5'7" turns you off for some reason.
Yeah, like, I don't know why. It's just like, as soon as you get to like, that point, I'm like, oh, I don't know. I don't know what it is. But I'm 6'5", though, so I could probably make, like, some exceptions, you know. But I don't know. Yeah, I just like shorter women. What can I say?
Yeah.
And remember, the average height of a Japanese man is 5'6". I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. Just saying. No particular reason behind it.
I'd like to touch on that diversity thing and how all women are quote-unquote sexualized. As you know, I play gacha game, and it's got its 5th anniversary, Fate, right? And you'd think of all the women they have that, you know, they'd be the most popular. While, in fact, it's quite the opposite. All the males are exceedingly more popular. Even though there's, like, what, a couple exceptions here and there, but, like,
I'm about to shoot my Danganronpa truth bullet at you. How many women are in the Fate Grand Order community?
I have no idea.
Would you say there's, like, would you say there's a large female audience, though? Like, even if you don't know, like... Or even, like, maybe not even a lot. Would you say it's, like, at least, like, maybe, like, almost a 50-50 split, even?
I wouldn't say 50. I'd probably go 40-30, best guess. But, like, literally, it's
that's
like
enough for me.
Almost completely that means, all guys.
That means it's the women sexualizing the male characters. What the fuck, women? Stop sexualizing me.
Stop.
Just kidding. You can sexualize the fuck out of me, dog. I was thinking about this.
We'll be accepting fan art.
I was thinking about this, actually. And I feel like I'm definitely gonna be the weirdo in this situation. Like
spit it, brother.
Without a doubt. So
spit it.
Okay, like if you have like women online, like, and I don't blame them for thinking this is weird.
Women.
Like if some dude like sends them an unconsensual dick pic, and that's not cool, or like is like being like creepy and like saying like, oh bro, I beat off to you all the time, like in like their Twitter comments. That's weird, right? Mm-hmm. How would you feel if someone said they jerked off to you? And this is
male or female?
Anyone. You can say whatever way.
Anyone.
Like, you can specify how you feel with male, female, 5'6", 800 pounds, whatever you want to say.
Okay.
If it's male, I'd be like, thanks, bro. Love you, too. And if it's female, I'd be like, it'd be kind of awkward say the least.
It would. You know what? That's funny. Maybe that's just because we don't talk to women personally.
I have three women right next to me. They always run away from me. They always run away from me. I'm convinced. I'm so intimidating.
Yeah.
Look, the women are talking right now. Can't you hear her?
I need some women to to unlock my heart, dude. What does Kingdom Hearts do again? They have the Keyblades or whatever. Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But like
the key brand.
If a guy says that to you, of course there's the chance that he's joking, right? In which case you would just be like, oh ha.
Well, are you saying women can't joke, Colin?
Wait, women can be funny?
Okay.
So I think I'm gonna be the real weirdo here. I only thought about this because I was watching a live stream the other day, and it was brought up, and I thought I was like, you know, that's interesting. And I thought about like the idea of somebody saying like, oh, I've like masturbated to you, like I've jerked off to you or whatever. I thought about that, and you know, maybe with some people, if they were like stalkerish and like they said it like a lot or something, you know.
They're yandere.
Like, not they were like weird about it. Like it wasn't like just like in a.
Oh. Okay.
Like I don't know what I'd like consider weird about, but I'd find it almost. I'd find it nice. I'd find it I'd find it like almost like a flattering. Compliment. I'd find it flattering. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'd be like, fuck.
Well, some women get compliments all the time. You know what I'm saying?
I know with women it's different because there's like the whole like rape culture thing.
That's just how the internet
works.
Yeah.
I'm not saying people should think the way I do, because the way I look at this is probably really unhealthy and not good. But I just, for me, as a coomer myself, you know, I would be like, fuck yeah, man. That's awesome. With a guy,
dude,
like...
with you next time, bro.
Like, first, if a guy said he jerked off to me and, like, he was, like, a gay dude or bi, first of all, I'd be like...
Oh, so it's, like, known? Okay.
Or, I don't even... As long as, like, I know it's not a joke. Like, I don't even know, like, the context. I'm just saying, as long as like I can be like, oh, this guy isn't kidding, you know.
Okay, so for sure it's not a joke.
Yeah,
okay.
I'd be like, fuck yeah, dude. I even gay people find me attractive. That'd be cool.
Okay, so like confidence.
And if a woman did it, dude, I'd be pogging. I'd be pogging in real life. if some girl, even if they were ugly, even if they were, or like, even if I didn't find them attractive, I'd be like,
good save.
I'd be like, hell yeah. Hell yeah, dude. However, if somebody's
it is like a good compliment.
If somebody, you know, is saying it like.
Hello?
Hello?
Weirded out.
Well, we just. Cut out.
A chance cut. Technical difficulties.
Yeah, but you know, to continue on what Chance is saying, I'd be completely fine if a woman said that, to be honest. You're just a little
quiet. Yeah.
God
damn it. You're better, yeah. I think.
Yeah. Wait. It just sounds a little
funny. A little quiet.
Hello.
Still the same.
Oh, and Chance, I think your profile picture for this episode should be the image that I just sent in the general with Death from regular show with his like really buffed out arm.
We can hear you, but
yeah,
it is
a little
quieter.
No problem. Yeah.
Okay. Try to fix this real quick. You guys talk about some random bullshit. I'll try to fix this. Sorry, audience.
Okay. I would take it. Yeah, I guess I would also take it as a compliment, no matter what.
Yeah.
If it was an act, like, yeah, I mean, yeah, obviously, if someone goes up to you and is like, hey, bro, I jacked off you, that's going to be weird, no matter who it is.
Oh, yeah, definitely, yeah.
It's like,
bro,
why
I
would they be telling you that? Like,
yeah.
Are they trying to, like, be like, oh, I want to start a relationship with you, in which case, that would be pretty weird. So.
Oh, definitely.
Hey, bro.
But you know, I think if it's it depends on the situation you're in. Say it's like online, like
sorry,
yeah, joke around and be like, yeah, bro, love
to the
you
microwave.
Too. Kissing emojis.
We're coming back to the microwave.
Okay, microwave time. Okay, that's fine.
Sorry, audience, you're just gonna have to deal with it. I made it 50 minutes with a fucking earbuds, so it is what it is. Yeah, but I would be very happy if somebody told me they masturbated to me. I'd be very pleased with myself that they found me attractive enough to beat their meat to or to finger themselves or whatever they
tribute time.
Also, that's another thing. What would they have been looking at?
Who knows, dude?
Because personally,
I don't post
myself everywhere.
Maybe I start thirst trapping on Twitter. Who knows, dude? Maybe they'll go to my Instagram and see that one picture where everybody's praising me as a clout god in front of Victoria's Secret.
Or the Club Penguin one? Where you
no, not the Club Penguin.
No, no. Oh, yeah, yeah.
But that one, I think
well,
I could
it be that one?
Club Penguin. yeah, I don't know. I'd be very happy, and then it would be even better if it was an attractive female, and they just so happen to do cosplay. Mm-hmm. That'd be cool. And maybe even like
below
maybe like even like go up a bit, and let's say they're from Germany. I don't know.
No, you know, should have sent below 5'6".
I want to cover my own ass here in case we somehow ever become famous. And somehow that reaches the ears of the person I'm insinuating. That's a joke, obviously. Uh-huh. Fuck That's off, not. Colin.
Bro,
fuck
you just
off,
destroyed
Colin.
The bit.
I'm destroying the bit because I enjoy my moderation position and I have a decent... Not a lot, but a decent bit of respect for their significant other as a human being.
Why not a lot?
You know, because I'm jealous of him. Because I'm jealous. No, we'll be honest. Stop. We'll be honest.
Bro, you're
about
jelly?
I'll tell you why I don't have a lot. And it's completely because I'm a bad person. Because I'm jealous that he has like...
I'm a bad guy.
I'm jealous because he has a hot ass girlfriend who's like my dream girl, and it's completely not his fault. It's absolutely just me being a bad person that very, very much would like to be in a relationship with his girlfriend, but that's not his fault. Mm-hmm. But also,
I wish that I could have Jesse's girl.
What are you, my dad?
You guys know that song?
Yeah, I know what you're talking
about. Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. I'm an old head.
Well, I mean, you are having your
wrong
first
generation.
Son, after all. I guess you are a little older.
Yeah.
I forgot that was this episode, but I did that bit already. I mean, not bit.
We need to go that on was, with that. That was funny.
Well, I mean, it's what happened.
That,
wait,
that
it was,
reality.
You were
it is
to
what
laugh.
Happened, I mean. It's fun. It is kind of funny that I'm like calling you out in front of the audience. Now all the female fans that may have had a thing for you. I don't know why they were over me, but because I'm, you know, I'm the audience favorite. But
yeah, I'm
yeah,
taking
sorry,
ladies.
And men, and
don't
men.
Try it.
Sorry, ladies.
Don't try it. Don't try jacking off to me. Not gonna work.
Colin's
wife
will literally find all of you and end you.
Not my multiple wives.
Colin's
yeah, Colin
Arabic
has two
prince.
Wives.
I'm Mormon.
He's half Arabic, half Indian. 100% God.
Whatever you want to believe.
You feel me?
I like the God part.
Me and Victor, though, we're bachelors.
Oh,
yeah.
I like how bachelors is like a, it's like a copy word for like
for being,
being single,
lonely.
Yeah,
bro, single.
Like,
ready
I'm
to
not
mingle?
A virgin, bro. I'm a bachelor.
No, I'm a player.
Oh my god! I feel like my audio is gonna be really quiet once I started using the microwave mic.
You should be fine. I can.
Yeah.
Do you remember about how long ago it was when you?
It was about at like the
49-minute
mark, I think.
Okay.
I think you'll be fine.
I can check your audio if it like dips down or whatever at that point, and I can adjust it.
I mean, you'll.
Okay.
Don't you mean management?
Yeah.
Yes, not me.
So
I don't
many
do
people
anything.
Working for us behind the scenes that we.
We can just sit on our ass, dude. We don't even need to do anything.
Well, I mean, I have to like make sure I'm funny next podcast, you know. You know, I.
Yeah.
Someone.
Yeah, you just gotta replenish your funny juice.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Wait, we were trying.
Saying,
I hate to go back to this, but that character Zaki, she can fucking get it, dude. Oh my god.
Mm-hmm.
She can masturbate to you. She has my golden membership tag to masturbate to me.
What about like the fat version? Can the fat version masturbate?
I prefer the Peter Griffin version of her.
The fat version can, but she doesn't get the gold membership pass. Like the normal Uzaki, okay. Like she can come into my DMs and verbally abuse me and just the normal one, she could be creepy. Like and DM me. She could like nice. Constantly
I'll
she
put
could
that
constantly
off on the screen.
DM me and like say in every tweet I put out and be like what I was saying was creepy and would turn me off. She can do that. The fat one though, she can say it once, I'd find it as a compliment. If she repeated to say it though, I would block her because I wouldn't block her, but I would find her creepy. I don't know. And listen, and I'm only partially joking. I would like to say I can't defend that point, and I'm a bad person for that. And if you're mad at me because you said what I find objectively hot can be creepy, but a fat person can't.
If you're fat and you're in the audience,
I'll die with you on that cross.
Let's work on that, buddy.
Yeah.
Let's get those gains.
But again, anybody can jerk off to me, and I'm not. If you're the Peter Griffin Uzaki, while I might be creeped out if you keep telling me, you can still keep jerking off to me. I don't mind.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I find you like a deplorable person, like just an absolutely terrible person, like Hassan Piker, you can jerk off to me. I mean, listen, I don't really like Hassan, but
the image I just sent, I saw this one as well. They see did the Love Live, but you know they just tanned them up a little bit
and made them
older. Yeah, pretty much.
The first one in the top left corner looks like an Arthur character.
You know what? Since we're on the
topic, I just want to finish up real quick on this point. Yeah, Hassan, okay. I really don't like you,
mm-hmm.
but you're a pretty attractive male. So honestly, I'd be honored if you jerked off to me, even though you're straight. I would be honored.
XQC.
I don't know if I want XQC. I think I'd feel a little uncomfortable if XQC.
Dude, he's a roommate. Yeah, what's wrong with
him? He's been in a long relationship with a really cool roommate. And I wouldn't fuck with Adept, dude. Adept? Adept seems like one of those girls who could just beat the shit. Well, a lot of people could beat the shit out of me. But, like, Adept, she just seems like she could fuck people up in a fight. Like, I don't know what it is. Like, she just seems like a strong woman. I don't know what it is. Because I wouldn't say she's buff or anything. She just looks like she'd be, capable at fighting someone.
It's because she's empowered.
Maybe. I don't know. I just get a genuine impression for her. And it's like, I don't even mean this, in a bad way or even, I guess I kind of mean it in a good way. Like, she just seems like she'd be, really good at fighting someone. I don't know. Maybe it's because I always see her, with XQC, and XQC definitely wouldn't be good at fighting people.
Is she, always, caters to XQC?
Yeah,
like,
or brings some
food. Shit.
Well, she's his mom. You know? I won't go into the whole thing because it would just kind of be lame to recap it. But I do remember this, I forgot the streamer who was telling you. I think it may have been the Austin show, but I don't remember. Somebody was telling a story how, XQC and Adept were at, a Misfits party. And how XQC was just mm-hmm. acting like a complete, child. Like, he was, running around the Airbnb with, a Nerf gun shooting people. And then it was, XQC had to go to, a fan meetup or some shit in the morning. And people were telling him to get into a hot tub there, but he didn't, have a change of clothes or anything. And Adept was, telling him,
don't do that. You're going to be, like, mad in the morning when you don't have any, like, clean clothes and you're, like, they're all wet and shit.
Oh, my
don't
God.
Go in there and act like you kept, like, messing with her, acting like he's putting, really like, his toe in the water or whatever. And, like, and she was, like, his mom, like, being, like, don't do it. You're going to be cranky in the morning. I just thought that was hysterical because I could totally see it in my head. I could totally see it.
Yeah.
Oh my God, like, that's so funny. Granted, it doesn't seem like anybody cleans XQC's room very often. I he's really entertaining, but goddamn, dude. Like, just when you end your stream for the day, just fucking throw out the shit next to your desk. Like, there's that one picture where it's just like, there's so much. There's so many, like, mugs, like 2 liter Coke bottles and shit. Like, fucking throw it away, dog. But you know, but you, oh, know, you know if the, it was eventually cleaned up, like, it was Adapt who did it. It was not XQC.
You know the images of, like, the quote unquote Redditors, and they have, like, the billions of soda cans on their desk, and it's like they can still see, like,
how do you let yourself get to that? It's like, you know what? I finished this Coke.
See,
not
the farthest I've gone with
not
that,
happening.
I'm being a little bit hypocritical here now in hindsight. When I have, like, mm-hmm. red solo cups at my house, I won't use, like, actual, like, glass cups. Because I'm like, why have another dish to clean when I can just, like, get something that I can just put some water in and then throw in the recycling later? But what I'd always do mm-hmm. is I'd grab a red solo cup, fill it with water, and go to bed. And it would be in my room. So then I would probably drink all of it throughout the night, like, if I wake up throughout the night or whatever. Or just while I'm chilling there, like, watching YouTube on my phone before I go to bed. It would be an empty one, and because I live in a multi-story house, I know I'm so privileged. Yeah, I live in
a
mansion.
Mm-hmm.
That's another thing Cosplay Cutie's just saying. I'm not rich, but it's a pretty nice house. And I would just start stacking the red solo cups as they built up. So I just kind of had one really big tower mm-hmm. of solo cups. But It's a little bit different. I will say I'm still being a bit hypocritical here, but it's a bit different than having, like, a shitload of mm-hmm. bowls with, like, dirty silverware in them, a bunch of empty bottles that still have, like, remnants. Yeah,
right,
it's just
water
cups that used to have water in them. So pretty much just plastic cups.
Mm-hmm.
There's
yeah,
that's
what,
like,
I mean. There's no, like, leftover
and,
like
yeah.
soda residue or anything. I don't know.
Yeah, I feel that.
Sorry, what?
But yeah, don't make fun of XQC or his
yeah.
mom is going to beat you up.
No, it's XQ Cow.
Yeah. I don't know. Dev seems like a really cool person. I don't, like, watch her streams or anything, but she seems chill. But again, she seems like she could also beat the fuck out
yeah.
of somebody. I don't know. She just seems like she'd be capable. That's all I'm saying. All right, one of you guys were saying something about the fucking, since this is, like, the episode where we're talking about blah, blah, blah or whatever. I don't remember which one of you it was, but...
Oh, I was just going to say, for the thumbnail, maybe I could do, like since we're doing, like, before and after, like, you know, with, like, the redraws and shit,
mm-hmm.
could we incorporate the image where it's, like, Alex Jones,
oh, yeah.
like, working out for 45
you know,
days?
You know, he used, like, the
more red.
It's red,
yeah. whatever, and he just got redder.
Yeah, yeah.
yeah, you can make
I
that
I thought
just,
you were
like, going to
say before
background.
And after, and in my head I just kept hearing the studio ghost saying the whole burn victim thing, you know? I'll give no context to that besides burn victim.
Oh. Bro, they got roasted.
Yeah, I don't...
You did.
I mean, I feel like we've been talking about it and really agreeing on it, or but do you guys really, like, do either of you think there is an issue with, like, having, like, a... objectively, like, a sexual, like, hot character, like, again, I know I keep bringing up this one, but, like, somebody like Pyra or Mithra, who have mm-hmm. big tits and big ass, or even, like, yeah.
No.
No?
I played the game. Mithra had yeah. good development. That wasn't...
I mean, the main... I think it's one thing off of that.
Oh.
I wouldn't say she had bad development, but I would say her character for the main game did kind of boil down to... Bro, Rex, you idiot, Baka, bro. Bro, Rex, stop sexually harassing me.
When you look at the DLC, it's like, she was like arrogant and shit. And then in the main game,
Torna blew it out of the park. Torna had much better storytelling. Not to say the main game had bad storytelling, because I don't want to contribute to this whole thing, this whole like hate bandwagon of Xenoblade 2, because there are a lot of people who like really hate that game.
It's not one
or again. It's not one or a lot of it really is like the whole, oh my god, I can't believe they made hot characters. As ridiculous as that sounds, a lot of it does come down to that.
I've seen a lot more.
One thing is to make a hot character, quote unquote, and another thing is to make a character that has, of course, appealing features, and then actually developing them, but then people like criticizing it, or the the makers of said character having to do an explanation for why this looks like XYZ.
When I'm beating off to said hot character, I see these tweets about Xenoblade 2, but I can't believe this. this character, Dahlia, how sexual they made her. And listen, that just ruins my mood, bro. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to jerk off.
Does it pollute your jack-off session? Oh, because you're scrolling through Twitter.
No. I'll go to like Google Images, and it'll just be there. And it'll like be like, oh, what the fuck, bro? How dare you say Dahlia is a sexual object? You just ruined me jerking off to her. Just wanted to point out my own hypocrisy there. But it's not even hypocrisy, because you know what? Bro. You can jerk off to characters who aren't sexual. I know the microwave just went insane right there, dude. I was tweaking. Really?
It didn't.
I think it's okay for characters. You can jerk off to anybody, but
unless they're fat, to be of age.
Yeah, the fat bastard tag. Get out of there.
I hate ugly bastard. Ugly bastard, and then DILF most times.
Well, I feel like DILF most of the time involves
ugly
bastard as well, or it's a dad raping their daughter. I mean, that's just
epic.
Speaking of epic, how do you guys feel about Epic Games and Apple fighting each other? You like that smooth transition?
Are they? That's cool.
I think it's Epic clearly did the wrong.
What's Epic doing?
Pretty much what it was.
So Epic implemented a way to get
it was
get
for
V-Bucks,
less money, and all the funds went directly to Epic Games and didn't like, because how it works with apps is like, I think it's 30% of the money goes to Apple or like
Android, it's 30.
Like the Google Play Store. Like I think it's the same for both.
It'd be Google.
I'm saying through the Google Play Store.
Just be Google. Okay.
Yeah, they get like 30% of the money. So Epic Games was another thing is what they were like encouraging their like audience, like, oh, buy the V-Bucks. They're cheaper. It's a steal, you know. So they would get all the money.
Oh, so Apple gets no money.
Yeah, which on one hand, I'm like, I don't think it's fair that like Apple should have like a monopoly on all apps, because unless you fucking hack into your phone and jailbreak it, you're only getting your apps from the App Store or a really shady third-party site. You can get a few apps, you know?
Only if it's jailbreak.
Sometimes you can do it like jailbreak. There's a few.
Really?
But almost all the time, it's like only jailbreaking. And even with the ones you don't have to...
Okay, but he's like Android gang. You don't have to jailbreak.
You have to like go into the settings and do some shit. But it's not like full-on jailbreaking your phone.
Okay.
I don't think it's fair that they get to have a monopoly on it, but it's also probably illegal for Epic Games to add that in. You know, that probably
broke their contract.
The terms of service of the App Store and shit. So...
Mm-hmm.
Plus, if Apple's not making any money from that, what's the point of leaving it on there?
The App Store and the Google Play Store removed Fortnite like fully.
Oh, okay.
Oh, so they actually already took action. Play Store did as well.
And then Epic Games said they were going to sue them or are suing them. As well as Apple,
they're not gonna
said they won't support anything like with Epic Games, like the like Unreal Engine shit. That's gonna be all gone from the App Store, and I assume the Google Play Store might end up following suit. You know.
Damn. Yeah. Okay.
You know, something recently had Fate did something as well because they recently had their 5th anniversary and they released a dancing rhythm game to go along. And one of the like things they did was like only, well, I think 500,000 people can download it. But one of the apps basically made it so they didn't have a restriction on it and as many people can download it. So they just, all they did was they just took it off the store, but they also took a Fate off the store because they were like, you didn't do this, so we're just taking that off now. So they basically took all this shit off, basically. Yeah. Because the, it's like Ooh app, I want to say. They basically just were like, anybody can download it. We don't care about what you said, even though it's probably one of the most things. It's one of the most popular apps in Japan because of how much money it rakes in. I love spending $200 on JPEGs, but it was just a free game just to go along. But continue with Apple thing.
I'm actually curious how the Fortnite ban thing is going to work on Android, because on Android it doesn't need to be on that like Google Play Store.
I don't know. I'm just saying it was just getting APK. I'm not sure if they're gonna, because they don't have quite the monopoly.
So I'm curious
over apps like Apple does on iOS.
Apple does, yeah. Because Apple, you have the app store. Yeah.
Unless you literally fucking hack your phone, pretty much.
Gotta do like Futaba. You're just gonna go.
I think you mean Alibaba.
Yeah, Alibaba.
She's 15, by the way, so you better not be sexualizing her. Because that would be annoying.
I swear, if you sexualize her, you can. Nia's okay, though.
Is it
Nia of age?
Nia, Nia's old.
Let's be careful with that, you know.
She's old, right? Well, is she?
It's a double-sided sword. Real quick. Right?
Is she,
Just check Discord.
She has, like, history with everyone, right?
Oh.
Nia is actually only 15 years old.
Ooh, thank God. I'm 15 as well.
People are going to actually 15. Believe that.
I'm 15. Uh-oh.
We're children.
Yeah, we're actually in elementary school.
I'm baby.
We're just using a voice changer right now.
Baby.
It's a really good one.
Like, really good.
Yeah. We made it ourselves.
Management.
No, I lied. Colin made it because he's so smart. Dude, I think managing. Yeah. The studio ghost also helped out as well.
I've been looking at him.
Oh yeah, no Jack. I'm not. We need to make that rule.
Chance, I thought we were supposed to do just stay only on the podcast, like that's our main focus. Look everywhere else.
This is related to the podcast.
That was a good burn, Victor.
This was related to the podcast. I'm not just playing fucking Minecraft for 3 goddamn episodes. For the entire podcast as well. I've been looking at like these images for like 2 minutes at most.
2 minutes too much.
Yeah, I was about to say that. This.
That's my saying.
All right. Well, since you guys are such pros here, why don't you guys bring up a topic then?
Migraines suck. All my homies hate migraines.
I completely agree with that. I've been getting migraines.
No, I disagree. Recently. They're pretty good.
Last time?
I think they're pretty good.
Yeah? You think so?
Oh, yeah? Cool.
That's a pretty hot take. But yeah, the other night I had a really bad one at I got at like 3 a.m. Like it felt like I was dying.
How much were you dying? Like, were you like burning alive, or like did you just get shot in the head?
Shot in the head. That's a good one.
Headshot.
Is Susan gonna cancel our video now because we said shot in the head?
As long as the gun's in the phone, the bot won't pick it up.
No, I'm gonna put a bunch of guns. I'm gonna
put squirt guns.
You're gonna have to make fan art of Uzaki Chan with a golden desert eagle sticking out of her tits. All right.
Hear me out. Hear me out. We all go onto a painting app and we each draw her, and then we put them like all next to each other.
I'll just end up making a stick figure with two big circles on it.
Right?
Yeah, that's not worth the effort. God, this is gonna be a tough one to make a thumbnail for. We gotta talk about something funny and not Uzaki's giant, juicy looking milkers.
I mean, those are pretty funny.
They're funny.
I would laugh.
As well as something else, but Susan didn't like Pokimane's ass, so I don't think she'll like Uzaki's tits.
Oh, yeah, we do have to be careful. Man, what? Fuck Susan.
Susan, I don't endorse what he's saying.
The bot won't pick up.
Susan would not have liked.
She's pretty
Susan
loose
would
already.
Not have liked episode 3.5. Yeah, oh, to the yeah. audience.
What episode you say? Join our Patreon below.
Yeah, so the Patreon.
I won't tell them exactly why, but I will tell the audience.
The lost episode ended at that.
I mean, it's not like I'm not going to go into why we decided not to release it, because that entirely defeats the purpose of redoing in episode 4. Let's just say it wasn't a good one. Colin looked like a real asshole. And let's just say I looked like a
pretty
piece of
shitty.
You know? We'll just go with that.
Yeah. That's true.
We talked about one vile topic pretty much for like 45 minutes, and it just sucked. But
yeah,
I thought it was pretty young.
No, we got it to an hour.
We talked about the one topic for like 45 minutes. We had an hour, but it's just a bad podcast. But you know, maybe one day we open up a Patreon.
I know. I like the thought process behind that. Like, they're paying us so we can give.
Yeah, that is funny. But they can't do that, dude. Yeah.
That's weird. Like,
What, for cold ones?
Yeah, you get to look at Chad's
the Patreon,
asshole.
You can see Max Moe.
So
yeah,
worse,
you get to look at his ass.
It's worse
than the last podcast.
It's
yeah,
worse
not
content.
Podcast.
I mean, that's subjective.
Do you want to look at Chad? Anything for views,
right.
Asshole?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we're not getting anywhere near the asshole. That's skating. That's getting too close to. But.
I think we should avoid the topic already.
Yeah, so maybe one day.
We don't
want to
go down that rabbit hole.
3.5 released. Well, yeah, we'll shit it right out.
What's other than Patreon? There's what? Coffee? Ko-fi? Isn't that one of them?
COVID-19.
I know what you're talking about, Victor.
I want to say that's
Give me a second.
Yeah.
I think it is Ko-fi. Or Ko-fi.
It's Patreon. Ko-fi. Yeah, I think it's Ko-fi. Or we could do, let's see. No, we're uploading it on a Pixiv.
Yeah, that's Ko-fi.
You'll go follow our Pixiv.
Okay, it's Ko-fi. Yeah, our Pixiv. That's where we'll be posting our Uzaki redraws.
Yeah.
I think we should just make an account on everything.
If you guys pay us enough money on Patreon, those two will do a face reveal. Yeah.
Oh yeah. What? Why not well, yourself?
I mean, I guess Victor kind of already has. Right. Yeah, his
I've always been true. Has
been his face. Because I think I want to say I said this in episode 3 that I was going to I think it'd be funny if we did the bit for a while where I'm one of the like swagger souls, you know. I just wear a mask all the time.
Oh, okay.
I don't think I could wear a whole suit of fucking armor, dude. Neither can he, though. Every time I see him, like, do an interview or anything, he has a helmet on for, like, a second, then takes it off. It's probably hot as fuck under there.
I bet he is hot as fuck.
Swagger souls, Crusader LARP helmet. Show me your Zwei hander, bro. Yeah, I don't know. I think that'd be interesting. Well, I have quite a few masks. I own a few masks here and there, so I could do like a different.
Oh yeah, what about Majora's?
Majora's.
Bro, you just stole my joke. I said that.
Did you?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
So like.
Well, on that note, I think this has been a great reading episode.
I don't
want to
end it yet, dude. I feel like
yeah.
What'd you say?
Nah, why not?
You don't want to end it? What? Make it even longer.
I don't know. We talked about big milkers for like an hour, which is better, much better than the last one.
Boy, boy.
But I don't know.
They're playing a funny thing.
Ah, fuck! I just had an idea. Oh, actually, you know, I have something that I kind of want to talk about because me, Colin, and the Studio Ghost talked about this one night, but you weren't there, Victor.
Mm-hmm.
Well, actually, Colin, you okay with me saying how many partners it would take till you said no to women? You don't
want me
to say that?
Is a no.
All I'll say is no. Colin was kind of lowballing it. I will not give a number. Victor.
Okay.
When it comes to like... Okay, well, actually, I have a few questions related to this. One, would you like fuck a girl like on the first date or whatever?
No.
Dude, I must be a fucking slut, dude. I'm such a man whore. Also.
Well, I also said my number.
Yeah, depending on if they were like if they intention. Remember? They were like in long relationships, so, I understand that.
It's not like hard.
For me, I really don't care. Victor, would you? I think this would be a good way to like go into it. Victor, would you ever date like a porn star? Or even like just like a sex worker, like a porn star, or even a stripper, which are not the same thing. Contrary to belief, unless it's like some really shitty strip club, it's not like the strippers are just fucking bouncing on dudes' cocks in there, you know. But in fact, I'm pretty sure a lot of times, even for like the private dances, touching is against the rules. I don't think you're allowed to. But
haven't you played GTA 5 and you play as the black guy and then you touch it and then you have to get
removed? Employees are even allowed to have any like sexual like have any sex with any of like the customers that come in, like at least on site, like
but
they can't control who they fuck like outside.
Yeah, you're right.
I'm pretty sure that's the case. Either way. The point is, contrary to probably popular belief, strippers aren't just fucking everybody that walks in the doors. But yeah, Victor, would you?
I would still say no to both.
You say, well, I know you say Colin.
I believe.
Yeah.
I believe if there's a strong connection, then I'd be fine with it.
I don't think.
Wait,
Victor said he'd be fine with it if there was a strong connection.
If there.
He said he'd be cool with it if there's a strong connection.
If it's a strong... That'd be fine. They're pulling in money, right?
Oh, okay, that's what you mean. That's okay. I thought you meant, like, if they had a strong connection with, like, the client.
No.
What?
Okay.
Me personally, I don't...
No.
I have a ton of respect for sex workers as a coomer, as somebody that admires their work quite a bit, you know. I don't think I could ever.
Coomers are. I don't think I could ever. You can use coomer.
I don't think I could date a porn star because I think I'd be too self-conscious. At least not like an active porn star. Like if they were like a retired one, I think I could probably do it. But I don't think like I could date someone who's still like working as a porn star because I'd feel too insecure about it. Not that I have anything against the work. I'm just saying I myself, I would feel, I don't know. I would always. No.
What, you got a small penis, bro?
Well, compared to fucking male porn stars, yeah. I'm not fucking rocking like a 1 foot long, fucking 2 inch wide dick, you know?
1 inch
I'm just average. I'm not going to sit here and be like, yeah, bro, I have like fucking 15 inches down here. Like, no, I'm just.
15
I'm just
inches.
Packing like 5 and a half, you know? I don't. What's the, I've never understood that idea, like, about lying about, like, your dick size. Because at least, like, lying about it to somebody, like, you want to have sex with. Like, they're going to find out.
Well, when you're with your bros.
That's one thing.
Just put the balls like, under the
like,
ruler.
Bragging, like, bro, like, online, you'd be like, bro, I got, like, a 10-inch dick, bro. Like, dude, if you don't have that, when they're going to know eventually. Like, that's all I'm saying. And then finally, if Victor would date a porn star, he's going to be fine with this one. But Victor, would you date any like Patreon and OnlyFans models, like people that like do like,
completely fine.
If you're cool with a porn star. And of course I'm obviously fine with it as well. I just think, me personally, I think I might want to be a photographer. I don't know. Even though so many people would see the pictures, I don't think I'd like the idea of some other, like, dude taking pictures of my girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little more intimate. Even though everybody would be seeing the pictures, I wouldn't like some other guy taking them. That would make me a little bit uncomfortable.
Now, on the photography subject, I actually I quite enjoy taking pictures. You know, when
especially a big titty.
I saw him like once, like he was like in an abandoned apartment like room, and he was zooming in. He was in New York. We were visiting there, and I was seeing him. He was zooming in with his camera outside the window to another apartment building across the road through the window, and it was some girl like getting undressed, and Victor was taking pictures of it. It was really weird.
Hey,
I don't know.
I did not.
She was also like 15. It was kinda,
oh my god!
I don't know. It was weird. But he seemed to be like he seemed to be taking some good snaps. I heard him making some really happy noises.
Oh my god!
What's everyone's snap score?
0.
Same.
I do not use Snapchat. I think I have one, but I don't use it.
I have Snapchat, but and I used to like try to be consistent with at least like a few of my cousins, but like I never use it. I would do like the streaks thing or whatever, like with like two of my cousins, but that was it.
Yeah,
I don't like Snapchat.
It's blue, so yeah, that's a classic.
Colin, because since the audience wasn't there for it, why wouldn't you be? Like somebody who did OnlyFans with Patreon model. Like, and by the way, just to clear the audience, when I say this, I don't even necessarily mean nudes. I mean, it could just be like Arrow or like Lewd's cosplay. Or just Lewd modeling, not even cosplay necessarily.
Okay. All right. So when I look at my life and my future and all that, I reflect on, okay, what do I think is going to make me the happiest in, say, like 20 years, right? 30 years, any time in the future. Men. And to me, that would be having a wife and kids, right?
Yeah.
That's just how I am.
Don't you mean you already have a wife?
Right. You have a kid right. coming? So I've already achieved that, yeah. right? Yeah.
Yeah.
But in those like professions and those lifestyle choices, I'll say, go against that of commitment and loyalty, basically, which is the two really very important things when you have like a family. So,
okay.
Yeah.
But what if like? Okay. Well, I damn that's even a step further than I thought. So like, what then? Like, let's say your girlfriend or wife, like, you guys go to the beach and she just posts pictures of Instagram and she's like, it's not meant to be sexual or anything, but she's just like in her bikini, like.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't
mm-hmm.
that?
Exactly, it's not meant
yeah,
to be sexual.
Like,
so anyone who like. Say jacks off to it is going to be seen as like the weirdo in that situation.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
You see what I'm saying?
We're all weirdos.
Yeah.
Then.
Yeah. I wouldn't.
Don't know.
What?
If some girl posts a picture of her at the beach and you start,
oh
yeah,
come on,
jack
dude,
off, bro.
Dude.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's weird.
You're saying it like you haven't done that.
I haven't.
I haven't done that.
Correct. Yes, I haven't.
Lying to yourselves. You guys are. If you were.
Oh no no! Of course I use Lee.
And listen, I don't care how creepy this makes me sound because I'm. So many people.
Very.
If you are scrolling through your Instagram feed or your Twitter, and you see some hot chick, in a bikini, listen, man, I'm doing it. All right, I'm doing it.
No, I'm certainly
I'd
not.
I'd probably
doing
go,
that.
Bro, nice. Like,
yeah, you go, oh, wow.
Scrolling.
Sweet ass, bro. And then you keep scrolling.
Nice
sweet
ass.
And then you make a trip. Then you make a cum tribute to it.
Yeah, bro.
I don't believe
the pokey
it.
Tribute.
Victor, you had to have done this, Victor. Maybe Colin in his, like, 1782 mindset
no.
didn't, but.
Okay, dude.
I'm so surprised.
To be honest, I just started using Twitter and I just started using Instagram. Like high school
I'm
year.
Just,
like what?
Oh,
no,
like
not
personally?
Even, like junior.
I'm just
yeah.
Okay, I'm all right with being the weirdo here. I'm just so surprised with you, Colin, especially. You're so like I don't know, like really like
why?
I don't even know how to describe it. So
I just
like,
think that's what's gonna
well,
make
no,
me
that's
happy.
Fine. You do you. I don't like care. I'm just surprised you're so like
yeah.
conventional about it. Like so like what like I don't need, I'm trying to find the right words to go about it. So like yeah.
Conservative.
So you
socially
sound
conservative.
Like, you sound like you're a Christian.
I'm not. I am much so not a Christian.
You sound like your values are like really like in the past, I guess. That would be the way to go about it.
Yeah, conservative. Yeah. I mean, that's where that term comes from.
I don't
you know.
I don't know. I'm really good at care. I don't really me myself, I don't really care. Because for me, I don't like I mean, obviously, I'm never going to see an issue with, like, Patreon or OnlyFans, like, modeling, like, cosplay and all that, because I've become part of that
uh-huh.
sort of community with, like, moderating for one of those cosplayers.
You are the community.
But I just, like, I don't know, like, and of course, like, you know, you put me back, like, a few years, and I wouldn't even be saying what you're saying. I would just be saying, wow, they're such, like, what a fucking slut, dude! Posting these pictures, you know.
Okay, so you think your perspective?
Oh no, I don't think it. It absolutely has. It's not a thing. It absolutely
okay.
has. I've.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't. I've gotten a lot. Not to say I necessarily like disrespected like sex work as much, but like I've definitely gotten a lot more respect for them. I think it's a legitimate thing to do.
Uh-huh.
And I think the biggest thing
oh,
for
yeah,
me,
I agree
gonna,
on that.
What pisses me off, like, and I talked about this with you and the studio ghost, Colin, is it really bothers me that we acknowledge modeling as a job, but then you have certain people that want to say, like, lewd cosplay and all that. That's being an e-stripper. That's so, like, to me, that makes no sense. Because to me, I look at, like, to me, I've always looked at it. It's just modeling, but they're not with, like, a company or anything or an agency. They're just doing it themselves. They're in control of their own job.
I think all of that is just like, how weird is it to jack off to said thing? You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, if you're modeling for, let's say, Victoria's Secret, right? And you're in like ads for like in like magazines and shit, and you know, of course, there's gonna be like little kids that might, you know, jack off to you because they don't have fucking porn, but like a grown man jacking off to you, that would be weird.
Why would that be weird?
Because it's like it's supposed to be advertising like underwear.
Yeah, but you, and okay, no, I can counter that. Magazine. The whole point of like lingerie and the whole point of like lingerie and stuff isn't so it can just be like worn like casually. Like that sort of thing isn't necessarily like comfortable for women to wear. I mean, even like a normal like standard bra and all that isn't really comfortable for women. Like if they had like, especially if they had like larger breasts. So the whole point of lingerie is for it to like spice things up and like be like more sexy in like the bedroom and all of that. So if you're modeling for that, even if it's just to show it off, like show off like the clothing, you know, it's right there. That's you're advertising something that is meant to be like a sexual thing. So I don't think it'd be weird for somebody to jerk off to it. Cause of course, as well, they're putting attractive women in this clothing for a reason, like in the ads, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's to catch your eye.
But I'm saying that they're, but it's attractive women
jack off
wearing clothing that's meant to make things more sexual and more attractive in like a sexual position, like in, like with partners.
Yeah, but
like I've never grabbed advertising magazine thing. And jerked off. This isn't the fucking. It's not the 80s.
Exactly.
No, but I've never done that. But I don't think that makes somebody weird if they do it. That makes no sense. Why? Why
because
is that weird?
It's for the you're advertising. The lingerie,
but why does it? Of, why does that you know, matter? Advertising what, it. Why they're jerking off to that over like porn or something? What makes it?
Because that wasn't the intention for the advertisement. Because for porn,
okay,
it's obviously
about,
it's like okay, we're
okay,
selling,
you
we're giving
this,
to
but you brought this point
because
up
they're
of
jack
modeling
off to
being
it.
Different from like what I consider to be Patreon, like cosplay modeling and all that. And you know, of course, like a lot of the lewd cosplay. I'm not going to try to hide it. Of course, it's intended to. We know what people are. We know what people are using.
Yeah,
it for,
it's sold
but,
with the intention.
Well, no. Don't say that. Don't say that.
Off to it.
We know people are using it for that, but it's not like these cosplayers or like Patreon models, because not all of them are doing cosplay, are going on there and just saying like going onto Twitter and being like, "Become my Patreon so you can pull your dick out and start jerking off to me." That's what people do with it.
What else would it be for then? What else would
it
be for?
They could just be what they do.
It does because there's nothing else you could do.
Okay,
with
so
it.
What about it? Wait, okay,
you know,
okay,
what?
Okay.
Can
but
I
what about
admire
like
it?
People that are like Instagram models? Are their point because not every post they're making is to advertise some clothing brand, but Instagram isn't behind a paywall either. So is their entire reason just so dudes can jerk off to them?
The Instagram one is interesting.
I think that's more
there's
of a
no clear...
self-satisfaction.
Yeah. Like
getting a heart.
They're getting like
they,
self-esteem.
So liked it.
I don't,
from that.
Yeah.
I think
you can say the exact same thing for Patreon and OnlyFans shit.
But
they're still...
It.
If they get popular enough off of their modeling on Instagram, they will get paid. They'll get sponsorships and shit like that through their Instagram.
Right.
And of course... A lot of those are going to be sponsored posts in that. but they're not just going to start on Instagram with a bunch of sponsorships or wearing clothing for brands getting money from that. They're going to start somewhere.
But they would still have their like personal stuff like Patreon and shit. Where you
but not
pay,
all of them do.
Pay them.
Not all of them
to
do.
See more.
Like people like I want to say like one of the biggest like what you consider to be an Instagram model is that like girl Summer Rae who used to be part of like the Clout House or whatever like FaZe mm-hmm. Banks and Rice Gum. I don't think she has a Patreon or mm-hmm. OnlyFans. But she's okay. made her
What's
living
her name?
Off of like being attractive, and posting stuff on social media. And she's making money off
okay.
of it. And I wouldn't like I think it's probably started
through
like
yes, sponsorships
and shit? But she probably does like YouTube and stuff now. I'm not aware of like the ins and outs of her career.
Right, yeah.
But I wouldn't say that is
right.
just for self-satisfaction or just so people can jerk off to her. I don't think that's a fair way to look at any of this.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Then what is it for?
It doesn't really matter. Like I don't get why like you're making like a big deal about it. Like I feel you're like condemning it. It seems like to me, at least to me, I might be wrong, but it seems like you're condemning the sort of like girls or even like I know some men even do like Patreon cosplay and all that. I of course don't know about them, but because that I'm not into that sort of thing.
Wait,
condemning like
the,
like women that would like. Go on OnlyFans and Patreon and all that and like show themselves and they gain money off of it. Like I don't want to throw out this term because this
okay.
seems a little bit extreme, but it almost feels a little slut shamey,
yeah.
if I'm gonna be honest with you. That feels extreme to throw out that term, but that
Okay.
That,
no, I would absolutely
that's
agree
what
that
it really
my,
seems
my
like
point
to
of
me.
View wouldn't be socially acceptable. My point of view isn't very sensitive to that. I can see how.
Because for me personally, as I've been like involved more in this community, I've become a lot more like aware of that sort of thing. Like, and being like, oh, slut shaming is. I mean, of course, slut shaming is really fucked up to most people in society. But like, especially with that sort of thing, like they really do go through shit. Like I don't want to be. I feel like influencers in general, they need to like. They need to be willing to take like mean comments or creepy comments to an extent because that's just kind of part of the job. But they go through a lot of shit, like, mm-hmm. and a lot of them, like, I know, like, this girl isn't necessarily like a Patreon or cosplay girl or even anything that I would. I don't think she's probably made like her career off of being attractive. But there was this streamer recently who's been having this like terrible stalking problem with this one guy, like, who is like he's trying to kill her, like he is actually trying to kill her. Like, mm-hmm. He's been, like, following her in public. He's waited outside of her house multiple times. And that's horrible. And they go through so much. And I think, personally, it's very unfair to think if you're going to acknowledge models as models and they're socially acceptable just because, oh, they're advertising clothing, but then say... Mm-hmm. Oh, somebody who's doing like lewd cosplay or just lewd modeling, or maybe you might even consider them like a titty streamer. Like they might not be a real gamer or whatever on Twitch, and it's clear people are watching them because they have like big boobs or whatever. I don't think that's really fair to mm-hmm. condemn them just because, oh, they're not advertising a clothing brand, but they're still making money because they're attractive. But they're doing it through themselves. Like, they're making money their own way.
Okay,
there's no middle.
So they're not profiting any external.
Yeah, there's no middle.
Yeah, okay,
It's like the people that enjoy them and find them attractive, giving them money, and it goes directly to them. And the only middleman would be like a platform
right.
like Patreon or OnlyFans. But they're not, to my knowledge, I do not believe they take a cut. I've never heard of that. But a modeling agency, they're
clearly
going to take a cut of the money. So I don't, for me, I will always acknowledge them as the same. I don't know. And I, as you said, a lot of people wouldn't like socially agree with you. I just think it's an unfair way to look at it. That's all.
Okay.
Because I mean, I remember I got into a big fight about this with a few of the other people in Discord, like Aiden and Jonathan and them, like months ago, in Blackjacks or whatever. Oh, they're e-strippers. And I don't even think a problem with being a stripper, honestly. But you know what's being said by that. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because they're not... It's derogatory. I personally don't think there's an issue with being a stripper or even a porn star. But you can clearly, when they're saying that, it's in an insulting way. And I don't think that's fair. And this isn't even because of course, I've softened up to these ideas because of being a moderator for a lewd cosplayer. But this isn't even just because of her. This is, like, my ideas across the board. I don't know. Mm-hmm.
But you said... so you changed because
because I can see the struggles like that they kind of go through more, and especially now that I'm working under I've been working under one of them for almost a year at this point, I especially can like I can sit there and empathize with them completely, or I think that's, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like I understand. Okay. I not to keep going, sir. I understand like people personally having an issue like if a girl sleeps with a lot of guys, but I think it's unfair that if a dude fucks a lot of girls, we're cool with that, you know. I think either like I understand why people would.
That's a big double standard.
For me,
I don't agree with that.
I don't think like, I'd want having, to be with a girl who sleeps with like a lot of guys constantly. But for me, I would never, like, have a number of sexual partners that I'm like, no, I absolutely not. I cannot date you. It would just, for me, depend on, like, how much you're having sex, you know?
Okay. And like I said, my number, not hard either. Just depends on the intention.
I don't know. I don't think there's really too much of a difference between like mainstream modeling and like Patreon and OnlyFans stuff. I don't think there's that big of a difference. I think people make more of a big deal out of it than they really should. I don't know.
Well.
Yeah, you guys might notice our other host is dead.
Hello.
Well, I was doing outer some had some problems to take care of.
Somebody was
returning back.
Yeah. What are the 7-year-olds? They got a little too loose in their chain.
Yeah. Right? Okay. So, in conclusion, guys, just to wrap up the whole podcast, if you're crying over a drawing. Having big tits and you don't have them, one, you need to really get some confidence for yourself, and two, you just need to shut the fuck up in general.
Pick up some weights, bro.
Yeah, two, pick up some, just do some push-ups.
Even though one of the hosts, we've clearly had a bit of a disagreement here, don't like slut shame people. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Oh, yeah, so- Don't body well. It's body shaming in general, truly.
No, it's that's not body it is, shaming. Right? It's
that's not,
yeah,
that's
no.
not a term.
Well, body shaming is a thing. It's not really a term. It's a thing. You know, like if you're like you
it's
disgusting
not the
fat
thing
piece
we're talking
of shit,
about.
Like that's technically body shaming. But like slut shaming is different. It's not about like their bodies. Well, it partially is because of course, attractive women are just going to be called sluts because they're attractive. A lot of the time.
I think you meant body count shaming.
Which is, it's just slut shaming.
Yeah.
Don't slut shame people. Who fuck, like, why do you care if some girl has had sex with a bunch of dudes? Like, you don't have to be in a relationship with them, you know? Like, get over yourself, dude. You're not the center of the fucking universe.
That is
true. Get over it.
I would not care unless I was trying.
Shout out to my women out there.
Get in a relationship with that person.
And unlike all a lot women. Of the things we've said in podcasts, which are very jokingly like Victor being racist, that's clearly a joke. I would say this one has been relatively serious, and especially this last topic. These are 100%. These are 100% my. These are 100%.
We're keeping it real.
I
wouldn't necessarily say I'm like a feminist or anything like that. Well, everyone is too simple. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not like an SJW. I just think it's fucked up how women are treated online. And then if you defend them, or not even defend them, if you just compliment them, then you're a simp. I'm not going to get into that whole fucking. I'm not even going to go down that spiral. I'm not going to go down that fucking spiral. But, because it's a downwards one. Just don't be an asshole. Don't slut shame people, because you shouldn't care. And you shouldn't care if a fucking drawing has big tits. Especially when you are applying your own convention of what normal is to them, when everyone's sense of normality is going to be different. Get over yourselves, and yeah. And again, smash that like button, hit the subscribe button, turn notifications on.
Hit the bell.
Now it's time for me to go back to objectifying women. If you're a cosplay cutie, fill out that girlfriend application. Because as we know, nice guys finish last. Hope you love the podcast. Maybe one day episode 3.5 will be released to the world.
We will sell you our shittier content.
Super shitty. Super shitty.
Even better.
I really hope you guys all enjoyed. We'll try to get next episode out a little bit sooner. It would have happened if it wasn't for episode 3.5 being horrible. Hope you guys enjoyed, though. See you guys later, and peace. Yeah.
Bye.
And also, it's a proven fact that generosity makes you happy.
Shout out to the University of Zurich. All right. For real, though. See you guys. Love you. Bye.
All right. See ya.
Bye.
Hit that like button.